taken my tooth out, and I put it on a rock and I can't find it, which is just boring, but that's not my priority right now. I need to get enough big logs to put on top of here and finish my shelter so that I can be nice and warm tonight. That is a dead bird. Yeah, it's been dead quite a while. But even though I'm not going to eat it, I can use it as bait. I'm going to make a trap. Hopefully I'm going to make more than one trap. Depends on how much daylight I've got. If that was a small mammal, that's definitely going to get killed. There's a surprising amount of weight in that slug. I'm skewering the meat of the dead bird, which stinks, onto the trigger stick so that it definitely won't come away. So if an animal pulls it, it will pull the stick with it. Okay, so you've got a supporting stick there, obviously, a sort of balance stick, and there's a little bit of my climbing rope in there, and then a tiny little toggle. And as you can see, it's quite sensitive. That's the first track set. It is bitterly, bitterly cold this morning. If I hadn't had that fire going last night, I would not have lasted through the night. But I did, and it kept me. We have a rat! We have a rat! Ha ha! Rat for breakfast. Ready for barbecuing. It's absolutely essential that you eat the organ meats. You can survive on the Inuit diet, or the carnivore diet, but unless you eat the organ meats, you start feeling really, really bad. If you've not got the complete nutrition that you need, unless you're eating almost all of the animal. It's a huge amount of iron. It helps with altitude sickness. First kidney. Tastes like steak and kidney pie. Tastes like home, that does. That's amazing. Might sound a bit disgusting eating rat for breakfast, but this is just valuable protein. And it tastes wonderful. Breakfast of champions.